quarter, CU7, introduced the capabilities for Dynamics AX 2012 customers to translate any report to any currency at any time. Along with that is the ability to use a new attribute filter called acquisition date. Acquisition date is the date that the asset associated with accounts such as accumulated depreciation were acquired. And the reason that it's an important attribute is the acquisition date is the date that is used when an account has a historical translation method, and that is the date that is used to get the exchange rate. So what we thought we'd do is step through an example and show you how you can use the acquisition date attribute and also how it's calculating using that particular date. So here I have a very simple report using accumulated depreciation, and you can see I have a US dollar amount and a Brazilian real amount, and it's showing an effective rate of 0.8106. Now when I drill down on this particular account, I have two balances that are making up home and depreciation. I have two different divisions. I have home and auto. I'm going to drill on the home. And you see that there are two transactions, a 966 in US dollars and a Brazilian real translated at 860. Now you can see that although the transaction date is February 28th, the acquisition date was on January 1st of 2014. So because these are on two separate lines, my effective exchange rate is actually 1.1235 between the US dollars and the Brazilian real. So let's go ahead and I'll show you how it's using the exchange rate from 1-1 and not from 2-28. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to remember my account 180301. Now let's go take a look in AX and see what the exchange rate should be. So the first thing I'm going to do is open up my chart of accounts and go to my shared chart of accounts and find my account 180301. So here you can see I use one, just a basic one called depreciation test for my accumulated depreciation, and that it's being translated at a transaction date, which is the equivalent to historical exchange rate, and that it's using an exchange rate type called April's rates. This is just something I set up for testing. Now when I open up the exchange rates and I look from Brazilian real to US dollars, you can see that although I have an exchange rate in January, it's using the rate that was in effect on or before the day of January 1st, which is that 1.123. And that's what you're seeing in Management Reporter. So what it will do is, regardless of when it was posted, so if it were posted in February, I would expect it to use the 0.75 date since no other exchange rates were used. But because it's using the acquisition date to get the exchange rate, it's using that 1.12345. And that's what you're seeing right here. So here's just a very basic example of how we are taking the additions to Dynamics AX around fixed assets and properly using the acquisition date to get the appropriate rate for currency translation.